Hello friends, welcome to our success journey. The first thing is, where shall we begin from? We shall begin our success journey from our mother and father. If only we had this one particular choice, who should be our mother, who should be our father, life would have been so nice. Every girl would have wished that now she should have had Barack Obama as her daddy and Michelle Obama as her mother. And similarly, we would have wished that, you know, Sonia Gandhi should be mother and Rajiv Gandhi should be our father. But then you can never have that choice who should be our mother and father. We have no choice on that, okay? And secondly, which caste, which community, which region, which religion, which country we should take birth, we have no control. And then what should be our height, what should be our complexion, should we look handsome or not, that is not there in our control, right? So our beginning is not in our control at all, means who should be our mother, you can't have a choice at all. But rest of it, which school to go, which college to go, which course to take, now what dress to wear, when to have your food, where to do your job, where to buy apartment, whom to marry, and then today should you watch this program or not, rest, everything is our choice. Now any wise person who want to become successful, now stop blaming your destiny, stop blaming your mother and father and start taking right choices. That's the first thing that one we should do. Second thing is, you must take the responsibility, that is not their problem. Recently I was in a college to give a speech. It was very hot afternoon, and by the time I finished my workshop, I had severe headache. So I spoke to the placement officer, do you have any medical shop nearby? I want to buy one tablet for my headache. He told me, Mr. Jayasimha, there is no medical shop here, but anyway, you are staying in our guest house, and very close by, we have the boys, you know, a hostel is there, and today, evening at 5 o'clock, the doctor is going to come. So it means every week once the doctor comes to check the health of people, that's a routine checkup. He said, you go, tell my name, take one tablet, and then I'll send some milk in the evening to your room, and then you can have milk and sleep. I said, done. So I went back to my room, had bath, and at around 5 o'clock, I was in that boys' hostel about to enter into the doctor's chamber. Now the doctor was sitting in a glass chamber. I was about to enter, there was a young man who came from behind, he pushed me, and then he went before me into the cabin. And I thought, such a mannerless brute, does not even have manners, don't have respect for others. I was scolding. But if somebody is with the doctor, normally we can't enter. So I was waiting outside for that guy to come. Since I was very close to the glass chamber, I was able to see what is happening. And I was near the door, I was also able to listen to what was happening. So this guy went inside, the doctor asked him, young man, what brings you here? That young man said, sir, what to do? My whole body is paining. Doctor said, what do you mean? He said, I put my finger here, it is paining. I put my finger, it is paining. I put my finger, it is paining. So the doctor's face became yellow, green, violet, red, pink. He pulled out a paper. He wrote blood test, urine test, ECG, MRI scanning, X-ray. So he said, get all the tests done. The boy, you know, with a maroon face said, sir, so many tests for what? Doctor said, you said, no, so much problem, paining everywhere. We need to do the whole body scanning. So that boy went up. Then I went into the doctor's cabin. I took a tablet, went off to sleep. This happened on day one. Day two, I was doing my workshop. Lunch time, the principal came to me. He said, Jayasimha sir, can we have lunch in the, you know, college canteen, college mess? I said, why? He said, if you have food, no, we'll take one picture with my students and I want to put in the brochure. Can you come? Food is good, come. So the principal, the placement officer, the mechanical branch head and computer branch head, we all went and had dinner. You know, the college canteen, the celebration, the kind of, you know, noise and then fun the students will have. We're sitting around a table and we're having our lunch, and then far away I could see somebody was singing a song, some people were clapping, some people were dancing, some people were whistling, and when one fellow was doing tabla, you know, was playing tabla on the table. I was eating my food and looking at those people, but suddenly when I saw the guy who was playing tabla, now suddenly tube light flashed my brain. Now that was the guy whom I saw yesterday, who's with the doctor, who said my whole body paining. I said, that guy said yesterday whole body paining, now he is with the doctor. And then how he became ordered? Curiosity took over me. I went and asked him, young man, you are the same guy with the doctor yesterday? He said, yes sir. We said whole body paining? He said, yes sir. And the doctor wrote some ECG, MRI, X-ray and that scanning. He said, yes sir. Have you got the test done? He said, yes sir. Have you shown them to the doctor? He said, yes sir. What did the doctor tell you? The guy was quiet. I said, hello, what did the doctor tell you? He said, sir, nothing sir. The day before yesterday, and I belong to computer science and department. We were playing volleyball match with the mechanical department. As I was playing volleyball, the volleyball came and fell on this little finger, sir. And this finger had a little hairline crack, this finger. So with this cracked finger, I am putting here my body paining. I am putting here my body paining. I am putting my finger in my body paining. I said, wow, what a great fellow. And where is the problem? Problem is with my finger. And now I am telling my head is not okay, my shoulders are not okay, my hip is not okay, my legs are not okay. And most of us are like that only. I am okay, but my mother is not okay, my father is not okay. And then now my teacher is not okay, my sister is not okay, my chief minister is not okay, my prime minister is not okay, the whole world is not okay. Now I am perfect guy. Perfect guy. That's what you always say. Now frankly speaking, that's not the case. The thing is, you now ask this question, no? You are judging other person by using what? You are using, judging somebody using this cracked finger. Now the question is your thinking little, you know, crack? Check that aspect, then thing is okay. Very easy to blame other people. And what do you blame? When you blame your mother, when you blame your father, when you blame your sister, when you blame your, you know, society, then you say, mistake is theirs, I am not at fault, I am perfectly okay. And in that escapism, so man want to escape from the responsibility. Listen, one thing, let us admit it in this right now, that we are responsible for our success, we are responsible for our failure, we are responsible for our happiness, we are responsible for our sorrow, and no one else. That's what Mahatma Gandhi said, no one can hurt you without your consent, no one can insult you without your consent, so no one can fail you. Friends, frankly speaking, in life, to become successful is easy, to fail is very difficult. The first step in the journey is you must start taking responsibility, okay? And take responsibility that I am in charge for my own life. I want to ensure that I want to become successful. And that's where we are going to start our journey. Oh, that's the first step I want to share with you. In the next episode, next step, we'll meet again. So keep watching. Thank you so much. See you. Bye-bye.